The Koch brothers are spending millions of dollars to buy influence at respected universities all over the country. They're trying to force colleges to teach outdated libertarian economic ideas that are all just massive giveaways to corporations. But students are fighting back against the Koch influence, and I have FSU PhD candidate Ralph Wilson with me to tell us about the movement to un-Koch college campuses. So, Ralph, we have the Koch brothers right now. I believe it kind of started with FSU several years ago, where they decided they were going to test a little experiment, put some money into the economics and business departments there, and now this has really ballooned into, you know, they are putting money in colleges all over this country. You were there at FSU. Unfortunately, it seems to be ground zero for the Koch money. So give us a little primer on what exactly they're trying to accomplish.
Well, FSU is definitely top five, and it was one of the first places where the public actually found out kind of what was going on, what were the details of some of these agreements. Luckily, it's where we've also been able to find out the most because of Florida's public records laws. And so what we found, and we keep learning new things, you know, pretty much, you know, every week, every month, the agreement between the Charles Koch Foundation and Florida State University in return for, you know, several million dollars and in partnership with other partner donors, basically is giving this foundation power over faculty hiring. They were giving hiring, firing power. They're able to create their own curriculum. They're creating extracurricular activities. They created something called the Economics Club, which is it wasn't disclosed that it was created in the Koch agreement. It's just passed off as an undergraduate club. They have a paid reading group for undergraduates. You get paid to read their literature. But some of the most troubling parts were actually how this agreement was put in place. In 2011, this was initially sort of studied by the Faculty Senate. They did a report that was published. Through our research, we actually found that report was not the original one. We found the original report, and it had been censored drastically. Some of the findings that were included in the original one that were omitted publicly were that the faculty actually tried to stop the agreement, or they asked to have a vote and whether or not to accept this money. They were told no. They were told that it was a done deal, and the agreement was put in place through threats and intimidation. And I'm quoting directly from the censored Faculty Senate report.
So this was something that it doesn't seem like the students wanted. It doesn't seem like the faculty wanted it at all. This was purely the Koch brothers coming in and muscling their way into the Florida State, I guess, administration, really.
Absolutely. So what we have, I mean, we basically see emails where the then chair of the department, Bruce Benson, who was he took a $105,000 bribe basically to stay the chair and carry out Koch's agreement, is emailing faculty in a very threatening way saying, look, if we don't take this money, you might not be able to teach the course that you want. We might not be able to have this department the way that we want it. And so basically we see the dean and the chair at the time threatening the faculty saying, if you want to teach the way that you want to teach, we have to take this money. But then it turns out that they didn't even really have to convince them that hard, because they didn't actually have a choice in the first place.
So what has been the student reaction now that all of this has come out, now that this is public, everybody, you know, that's paying attention really knows what's happening? What is the reaction among the student body there?
Well, it's actually very interesting. So sort of in line with the Center for Public Integrity's reporting, you know, one of the things that they point out is that Koch and their partner donors are very focused on harnessing talent from the university. So they refer to what they call a talent pipeline. And so this actually creates quite a rift, because you have students who are for academic freedom and who are for exposing any kind of undue influence. So several student groups that we're involved with are pushing for that. Understand the problem with the Charles Koch Foundation. You also then on the other side have students who are part of that talent pipeline, who are part of the economics department, who are actively seeking a career path in Koch's, you know, giant liberty machine. And they see this as a very lucrative future. And it is very lucrative. They're being offered, you know, scholarships and travel, go to these conferences and things like that. So they have come out and been very, very protective and very defensive of critiques to the Koch Foundation, to the point where they've actively confronted people yelling, some on the verge of tears, tearing down people on the internet and things like that. So there's there's it's a very polarizing issue on campus, but I would say a lot of the pro-Koch people are actively involved in that programming.
And is that kind of typical of what's happening at some of the other schools where the Kochs are involved, or is this or is your experience only limited to what's happening right there at FSU right now?
You know, what we're seeing at FSU is absolutely just a microcosm, and it's also in a lot of ways typical. I mean, at FSU, not only is the economics club, you know, created by the Koch agreement, but there's at least four other groups that are like funded by, you know, Koch front groups, receiving money. College Libertarians have received money in the past. You have FIRE, the Foundation for Individual Rights in Education. So you have a bunch of student front groups that are on campus. And these groups are national. These are groups that are on campuses all over the country. That are basically, you know, AstroTurf student groups. And so the same thing that we see playing out on the national scale is now taking place on the university.
It's absolutely unbelievable. But unfortunately, look, we're out of time here. But Ralph, keep up the good fight. You and everyone at FSU, this is a big issue. I hope people understand this, because this is essentially libertarian, free market, let big business do whatever the hell they want indoctrination. And it's got to stop. I mean, that's the bottom line. And without people like you out there fighting this, we probably wouldn't even know that it's happening. So thank you for everything that you do. And please keep up the good fight.
Yeah, likewise. Thank you.